Warning. The following motion picture is a work of fiction. Situations depicted here have been satirized for comedic purposes. Any similarities between airline situations shown here and the actual Independence Air working environment is purely coincidental. The people depicted are real, however, and that's cool, because they're VPs and they do dumb stuff in this movie. Rock on.
Okay. Well, Carrie, that sounds great. All right, tell Tom I'll meet you guys there. Bye-bye.
Hi, my name's Dave George. As part of senior management, I find that some of the most rewarding stuff I do all day is read the emails that we get off of the website. They're interesting, but one of the things we found is that people feel like they've been burned in the past by the airlines. So it's neat to see some of the suggestions folks have about this new airline. Here's one from a gal named Tina. Now what Tina's asking here is, what I really, really want is friendly customer service. Well, let's ask Jerry Kaler what the customer service team is going to be doing for people like Tina.
Tina, you read our minds. We are absolutely committed to making sure that along with everything else, you are going to get friendly service. It starts the moment you begin your journey.
Just a little surprise for the kids. I think they're going to enjoy it. Man, I missed you guys. I'm Jerry Kaler, and my customer service team is there for you.
Our next email comes from a guy named Nick. Nick says, I wish the airlines would make better use of technology. Well, I think there's no one better to handle that question than our own Duffy Meese, Vice President of Information Technology.
I couldn't agree with you more, Nick. We at Independence Air believe that computers are the key to a smooth passenger experience. We actually consider them to be our friends. As you can see, Eileen here, she is our most powerful, most modern... I'm telling them that you're our most powerful computer. Computers are smart. They're even smarter than Alex Trebek. We spared no expense on Eileen and her friends because we believe that they're... I know, Eileen. Can we talk about this later? Can we talk about this at home? I'm Duffy Meese, and I'm very lonely.
Wow, thanks, Duffy. That was something. Our next email comes from a fellow named Russell, who asks the following. One thing that really makes passengers angry is when our luggage is tossed about and damaged. Please ask your people not to do this.
Well, I think the person to address that point is Senior Director at IAD, Rick Pelk.
That's a great point, Russell. And I'm in total agreement. We don't throw bags at Independence Air. We recognize that you may have breakable items in your bags. Maybe you're like me, and you collect rare and unusually shaped potato chips. This one, I bought from a man in London. It looks just like President Garfield, doesn't it? We go to great pains to make sure that your luggage arrives safely. Each of your bags will be wrapped in at least 3 layers of bubble wrap. Then, after being carried gingerly from the main terminal to the staging area, it is painstakingly loaded. Not only will we not throw it into the cargo hold, it may not go in there at all. If there are extra seats on board, it will be gently buckled in and served a cold beverage. And this one here looks a lot like President Chester A. Arthur. Sometimes I like to make them argue. You can't appoint Senator Conkling as head of the Federal Customs House. I can and I shall, Chester. I don't care what the Pendleton Act says. It's fun, but you have to be careful. They were strong presidents, but very fragile potato chips, like your luggage might be. My name is Rick Pelk, and I take your luggage seriously, very seriously.
Oh, rats.
Well, thanks, Rick. That was interesting. And now we've got an email from a fellow named Steve who asks a...
Come on. What have we talked about?
Sorry.
Well, whatever. The point is, our customers have questions about Independence Air. This last one comes from a guy named Steve, who asks the following. The only thing I ask is that you work very hard to make sure that your flights go out on time. I think this is one we can hand off to Bill Brown, Senior Vice President of Maintenance and Operations.
Steve, buddy, you're absolutely right. Getting our aircraft out safe and on time is the most important thing I can do. I know time is important to our customers, and getting you there on time is extremely important to me. I make it my sacred duty to ensure you get out on time. You see, I take time very, very seriously. When I wake up every morning at 5:39 a.m., I'm thinking about time. You could say that I'm obsessed with time. From the minute I get up, I'm looking for ways to do things faster. Finding ways to save time is what I do.
Up and down. Up and down. Up.
6 minute abs, please. I do them in 4 minutes, 20 seconds. Don't try this move at home. Took me 4 years to master this maneuver, and I don't want you getting hurt. Then it's time for breakfast. 3 minute egg, who's got that kind of time? By the time I get to work at 7:04, or if traffic's bad, 7:09, I'm raring to go. You see, my entire day is centered around making sure your flight leaves safely and on
time.
Hey,
Bill. Looks like that Boston flight's going to be late unless we get a hold of a replacement Fitzer valve.
Okay, do this. Take 625 and swap it out for 605.
Take the Fitzer valve on 625 and repack it with 509 composite sealant so it can be recalibrated. Then take the flux capacitors from 625, 622, and 619 and join them with a wire terminal so you can free up the cabin on 605. Then reconfirm stages 139 and the number 2 inch on 625 so it'll accept the Fitzer valve on 631. When you're done with that, rip the engine on 625 at 7,000 RPM.
And that'll get the Boston flight out on time. Got it?
Got it.
You the man.
No, you're the man.
No, you the man.
No, you're the man.
Hey, I could argue with that guy all day, but who's got that kind of time? By the way, I am the man.
Hey, Bill, it took some doing, but we got that Boston flight out on time.
Hey, way to go, guys. Take an extra 47 seconds on your break. Good night, Nicole.
Good night.
We work around the clock at the hangar, but when my shift is done, I head home. It's a 23-minute drive, exactly as long as the first side of Led Zeppelin IV. Pretty sweet. When I arrive home each day at 7:48 and a half, I know my team and I have done everything humanly possible to get you where you need to go, because that's what we do. We get you there, safely and on time.
I'm Bill Brown, and I'm committed to operational excellence and getting you there on time.
Oh, Bill, I'm waiting for you upstairs.
I'll be back in 94 seconds.